Hello friends, this is Shruti Vanjin from Vyans Medical Academy. Here I am there today to describe about the most important topic, neural control and coordination. What is coordination? It is the process through which two or more organs interact and complement the functions of one another is called coordination. For example, when we do physical exercises, we can observe that our heart rate, breath rate, muscle contraction as well as the oxygen necessity keep on increases. And once when we stop the exercises, we can clearly observe that the activities of our nerves, heart, breath as well as our contraction decreases gradually, relaxes and reaches their normal state. And now, let's question ourselves, how are all our organs coordinated? How are they being regulated? Who is coordinating all this? Yes, I am talking about the highly integrating organized system along with an amazing organ, the brain, which is also called the think tank, together consists the nervous system. It consists of nervous system, which gives a point-to-point coordination and it gives a very quick coordination for our body. In this chapter, I'm going to discuss about the nervous system, the neuron, and finally the human brain. Firstly, I want to discuss about the nervous system. The nervous system in the lower vertebrates is very simple. As well, if we see in the higher vertebrates, it is very well developed. As we all know that the nervous system is composed of specialized cells called neurons. And the nervous system is basically divided into two major systems, the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. The central nervous system consists of brain and the spinal cord. It is the major site for information processing and controlling, whereas the peripheral nervous system includes the nerves which are associated with the CNS, that is brain and the spinal cord. And the peripheral nervous system is further divided into somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. Somatic nervous system is the one which relays impulses from the CNS to the skeletal muscles, that is nothing but voluntary muscles, whereas the autonomic nervous system transmits impulses from CNS to the smooth muscles and also involuntary muscles, and it is further divided into sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system, it is the system which usually inhibits our glands and it increases our heart rate as well as our breath rate. Whereas the autonomic nervous system consists of the second part, parasympathetic nervous system. This gland is usually stimulation and which helps in the reduction of our heart rate as well as our breath rate. This is all about the nervous system. And now let's discuss how the nerves are being transmitted. This is the duty of a neuron, which is a microscopic structure. Though it is a microscopic structure, it is having a complex organization. Have you ever wondered, being a small structure, how is this neuron transmitting such great impulses? Though it is a small structure, it is gonna give such great impulses as well as it is making the things very perfect because of its complex organization. If we see the structure of neuron, the neuron is composed of the cell body, the dendrites and the long fiber axon. Cell body consists of cell cytoplasm and the nucleus, and it also consists of Nissl granules, which are granular bodies, and it also consists of some typical cell organelles. Whereas the dendrites are the one which are short, branched repeatedly and are projected away outside the body, and they transmit impulses towards the cell body. Whereas the axon is a long fiber which is terminated at the ends, and the distal knobs are a round structure which are called the synaptic knobs, which are useful for the transmission of impulses. And the axon is the one which transmits impulses away from the body, and it does not give the impulses towards the body, but it transmits these impulses away from the body. This is about the neuron. And neurons are of two types, the efferent fibers and the efferent fibers. Efferent fibers are the one which transmit impulses from the cell organelles to the CNS. Whereas the efferent fibers are thin and they transmit impulses from the CNS to the tissues or organs to regulate them. This is all about the neuron, and you can see the differences between the axon and dendrite also to make your study easy. And now finally let's discuss about the human brain, which is very interesting and important. The human brain, we all know that it is a central processing unit of our body. It acts as a control and command system. We know that brain is well protected by a hard shell called skull, and the brain is having three meninges, the outer dura mater, and the middle is thin arachnoid, and the innermost is the pia mater, which is not contact with the brain tissue. And let us study further for its parts and functions. And you can see that brain is divided into forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. Forebrain consists of olfactory lobes, cerebrum and diencephalon. Let us first discuss about the cerebrum. Cerebrum is the major part of the brain. As we know that cerebrum is divided into outer cortex and inner medulla. Outer, you can see the differentiation over here. The cortex is grayish in color because it contains the cell bodies of the neuron, whereas medulla is in whitish color because it contains fibers which are covered with the myelin sheath. And also the cortex has some sensory areas, motor areas as well as association areas, and cortex is responsible for the brain folds. And cerebrum is divided into two parts, that is right and left, called the cerebral hemispheres by a deep cleft passing in between them. Both the hemispheres are together connected by a tract of nerve fibers called corpus callosum. And as I already told you that cortex has association areas, and their association areas as well as with the olfactory lobes, it constitutes this diagram. As you can see, there are four lobes which are written in yellow colored, and it also contains areas which are written in pinkish color. And this is the frontal lobe, and this is the parietal lobe, and this is the temporal lobe, and this is the occipital lobe. And you can see the respective areas are located in the respective places. To make your study easy, I have prepared a table for you to understand. So this column represents the area, and this is the location where the areas are located, and these are the functions which they give. First, let's see cerebral cortex. It is located in the frontal region, and it is a seat of thinking, intelligence, knowledge and memory. Whereas the motor area is also present in the frontal region, which helps in voluntary movement. And the Broca's area, it is present in the frontal region, it gives analysis to speak. And this is the auditory area, it is located in the temporal region and it gives analysis for sound. And this is olfactory area, it is located in the temporal region, it gives analysis for smell. And the Wernicke's area lies in parietal and temporal region, which helps in analysis for language. Whereas the gustatory area is present in parietal region, it gives analysis for taste. And this is the somatotic area, which is present in parietal region, it gives touch, pressure, pain, and it gives knowledge about our position and the space. And finally, the occipital area, it is present in the occipital region and it gives analysis for vision. This is the end of the cerebrum and olfactory lobes. And let's discuss about the final part of the forebrain. It is nothing but diencephalon. Diencephalon consists of thalamus and hypothalamus. Thalamus is the organ which is a major part which controls our sensory and motor area signaling. And hypothalamus is a structure which have a specialized center which helps in our body regulation and urge for eating and drinking, and it also secretes some hormones. You will be studying about the hypothalamus in detail in chemical coordination and integration. So an important point to note here is that the inner part of the cerebral hemispheres and a group of deep associated structures like amygdala and hippocampus, they both together constitute a system called limbic system, which helps in the regulation of sexual behavior. This is the end of the forebrain. And coming to the midbrain, midbrain is located between the diencephalon of the forebrain and pons of the hindbrain. A canal called cerebral aqueduct or iter, it passes through the midbrain. And then you can see the four round swellings at the dorsal portion of the midbrain. These are called corpora quadrisimina. And the first swelling is called first paracele, and the second is called second paracele. And these both are called superior conoculi, which help in our sight. And this is called diocele, and this is called mylocele, which together call the inferior conoculi, which helps in our hearing. This is about the midbrain. And coming to the last part of the brain, that is hindbrain, it consists of pons, cerebellum and medulla. Let's discuss about pons. What are pons? Pons are the integrating structures which help in interconnecting the different regions of the brain. Hence it is called the relay center between the spinal cord and brain. And next, coming to the cerebellum. Cerebellum is a structure which gives surface for the neurons to accumulate in them by providing a convoluted surface. This is about the cerebellum. And finally, the medulla oblongata. It has some specialized centers called respiratory rhythm center, which regulates our respiration, and it also has cardiovascular reflexes, and it also contains vomiting center as well. It also helps in our secretion of our digestive enzymes. And pons also has a special center, that is pneumotaxis center, which is regulated by the respiratory rhythm center in the medulla. This is about the three different parts of the brain. An important point is midbrain and the hindbrain together constitute the brain stem. This is all about the structure of the human brain. Well, friends, now we have come across how the brain is associated with multi-works, and thus it is called as a computer of our body. This is all about the human brain and the chemical coordination. Hope you all understand my lecture, and this chapter contributes nearly 4 marks. If you see in 2017 NEET, you were asked 3 questions from this chapter. So do not neglect this. It is very important to score and easy to score. And do well in your exams. And Vyans Medical Academy wishes you a very good luck for your 2019 NEET. Thank you.